Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I am Dr. Alpesh Dafda, and in this 28th video class of DIP, we will study inverse filtering in digital image processing and its implementation in MATLAB. What is inverse filtering? Inverse filtering means the reverse filtering. See, we have already studied filtering in our previous video classes, the high pass filters, low pass filters, etc. And inverse filtering means we will be doing reverse filtering to nullify some particular action. For example, the image is blurred due to motion or shaking of the camera, then that blurring is smoothing. Smoothing is low frequency signal. So to reverse out that, we will be using an inverse high pass filter and hence de-blurring our image. Similarly, say the image is corrupted with noise due to some electrical interference, and that noise is a high frequency signal. So to remove that high frequency signal, we have to use a low pass filter, right? So to remove the noise, we'll be using inverse filtering or a low pass filter so that noise is removed. But if both blurring as well as noise is present in the image, then we have to take some different approach. Okay, so we'll be studying inverse filtering in this video class, and of course we will implement it in MATLAB. Let us start. Starting with the slide that we saw in our previous video class, that the estimation by modeling can be done with three different possibilities. First possibility is we have the complete knowledge about the blur. Okay, then we can apply the deconvolution or inverse filtering. Why? Because we know that what type of blur it is. But if along with the blur, if noise is also available and we have partial knowledge about the blur or degradation, at that time we can use Wiener filter. And if we do not have any knowledge about the blur and the noise, we can use blind deconvolution, right? So we have seen this image degradation and restoration model in 23rd video class. For this model, as well as for understanding any image degradation and restoration, this equation is important. So this equation says that our output image g of uv is obtained by multiplying the degradation function with the input image f of uv plus capital N of uv, which is our additive noise that is present. So in this equation, what we want is f of uv, right? Why? Because f of uv is our undegraded image. So to obtain f of uv, if we make f of uv as the main part of the equation, then we will obtain this equation, that is g of uv minus of n of uv divided by h of uv. Okay, so this will give us our undegraded image. So in this equation, if we assume that this term or noise is zero, okay, and we have full knowledge about the blur or the degradation, then using deconvolution or inverse filtering, we can obtain our undegraded image f of uv. So if this is zero, this term will not exist, and we can obtain f of uv by inverse filtering. But say noise is not zero and some noise is present, and h of uv is very very less, that means this term will tend to infinite and the image will be having a lot of noise, and that is the reason inverse filtering is not a good choice for obtaining the undegraded image. So if we want to get rid of the blurring and noise, the simplest method is by applying inverse filtering or deconvolution. Blurring is smoothing or low pass filtering, so deblurring is sharpening or high pass filter, and hence inverse filter acts as a high pass filter. But remember, the high pass filter will also pass noise, which is a high frequency signal, right? So noise will also increase. The deconvolution assumes that blur has a property of point spread function or PSF, which can also be called the impulse response of the system. So the input image gets convolved by a blurring function h of xy and changes to g of xy. So to retrieve f of xy from g of xy, we take the inverse of h of xy. Assuming that noise is zero, in this equation, if the noise is zero, f of uv is equal to g of uv by h of uv. Let h inverse of uv is equal to 1 upon h of uv. So f of uv is equal to h inverse of uv into g of uv. So undegraded image can be obtained by multiplying in the frequency domain the inverse filter to the degraded image. If we take the inverse Fourier transform of the above equation, then this multiplication will get converted to convolution. So f of xy is equal to h inverse of xy convolution of g of xy, and this shows that if we convolve the blurred image with the inverse of blurring function, we get back the original image. So this is the blurred image we are convolving with the inverse of blurring function, we will obtain the original image. But as I told you, what is the problem? If noise term is also present and if h of uv is zero, the second term, that is n of uv by h of uv, can have large values, resulting in amplification of noise, as this term tends to infinite. Because this is zero, that means this is infinite, and infinite means there is amplification of noise, and therefore the inverse filtering is not used in the original form, and we have to go for Wiener filter. So a filter that will remove the high frequency noise also, right? I hope it is clear. Let us implement this inverse filtering or deconvolution in MATLAB. So as usual, I am reading a image, cameraman.tiff, and subplotting the original image in one of the portions. Now to this original image, we have to add some blurring so that we can de-blur it and show you the effect of inverse filtering. So as I told you, for blurring, we have to implement the PSF or point spread function. Let us implement point spread function by using fspecial command. So this fspecial motion length theta is a special filter that introduces motion with length 21 and theta 11. Fspecial motion comma length comma theta returns a filter to approximate once convolved with an image the linear motion of a camera. Length specifies the length of the motion and theta specifies the angle of motion in degrees in a counterclockwise direction. The filter becomes a vector for horizontal and vertical motions. The default length is 9 and the default theta is 0, which correspond to a horizontal motion of 9 pixels. Here we are giving a length of 21 and theta of 11. Now I will be adding this point spread function variable, which has a motion blur to unblurred image, and we'll naming it a blurred by using IM filter. So IM filter a PSF convol circular will perform multidimensional circular convolution filtering on a with PSF, and my image will become a blurred image, which I'll be plotting in the second portion of the output. Now what I have done, I have blurred my original image. Now I know that blurred is done by using PSF. So I know this is my degradation function. I have the knowledge of this degradation function and remove this degradation function by inverse filtering or deconvolution. So deconvolution, deconv reg, that is regular, this is my blurred image, and PSF will deconvolve my blurred image with the degradation function that is applied to the image or the knowledge of the degradation function that we have, and I'll be plotting this in the final subplot. So let us run and see the output. So this is my original image in which I have introduced blur. To restore this blurred image to the original version of the image as if it was not blurred, I will be applying inverse filtering or deconvolution and obtain the restored image like this. So you can see that the restored image is a very good estimate of the original image. But this is the case when no noise is present. Okay. Say for example, if we also add some noise to this blurred image, then what is the output? Let us see. So I'll be adding noise to this a blurred image by using IM noise function. So I'll be adding Gaussian noise to my blurred image and then doing the deconvolution. So let us run and see the output. So now you can see here, this is the original image in which I have not only added the blur but also added some noise, as you can see here. And when I try to restore the image using deconvolution, you can see restored image is having lot of noise, and in fact, I am not obtaining any good part of the original image. So that is a problem with inverse filtering, which can be removed using the Wiener filter, which we'll be learning in the next video class. That is all for this video class. In the next video lecture, we will understand the Wiener filter. Thank you very much.